What if it were the year 2024? It might be difficult to imagine right now, but what of this new normal might be here to stay? Zoom calls come to mind. Who would have thought that Zoom the service would so quickly come to represent an entire industry of virtual communication? It's like saying Google or Kleenex or Popsicle. Now, I know most of you may hope that Zoom goes away when we stop saying social distancing, but let's take a step back. Most businesses were already using some form of virtual communication before the crisis. Nobody thought much of it until everything turned virtual overnight. Our meetings to our birthday parties, morning yoga, conferences, everything in between turned virtual. And now we have a new buzz phrase in our vocabulary, Zoom fatigue. I have a friend who relates Zoom of 2020 with email of 1995. Both of these services are changing our lives. The difference here is time. We were forced to adopt Zoom over a matter of days rather than the luxury of a long decade for email. And just as we learn to, dare I say, embrace email, I think we'll learn to like Zoom too. What's good about Zoom? Connection. We quickly taught every generation, from our preschoolers to our great-grandparents, to connect virtually. It's been clunky, sure, but what would we have done without Zoom humor in the early days of stay at home? Those Zoom memes and fail videos were just the laugh we needed. What's not so great about Zoom? Connection. No matter what we do, the Zoom call will never have the same feel or energy of face-to-face. But it's close. I believe the body-brain connection is the key to more productive and collaborative meetings while we ease that fatigue. And since Zoom isn't going anywhere anytime soon, and most of us don't have control over how many meetings we're invited to every day, I am here to share my body language expertise and give you the power of the body-brain connection. I'm going to use a song to help us all remember. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes. You know it, right? So head. Smiling really does go a long way to helping our perception on Zoom. And that same smile can go a long way to prevent those negative facial expressions from creeping onto our screens. And a smile tells our brain that the meeting's not going so poorly, and that helps with our fatigue. And let's face it, some of us have listening faces that tend to be a little more, shall we say, upset or angry on screen. So shoulders. Our shoulders, chest, and head are the main communicators of collaboration and relationship. This is what we use when we hug someone. These are the body parts that soften when someone falls in love. And this is what we see on Zoom. We can use more upper body movements to set the stage for more collaboration and relationships on Zoom. Knees. Now, I never thought I would tell anyone to wiggle and fidget more, but nobody can see you from the waist down, so wiggle all you want. We weren't wired to stare at a face in a box all day, much less be watched ourselves. So when you feel that stress and fatigue start to creep in, you can throw in some bee's knees and wiggle your ankles and tap your toes. Nobody will see you. And toes. The next time you end a meeting, I want you to have your toes lead you on a walk around the room. We need to tell our brains that we are task transitioning, and this is what this physical break does for us. That is one of the main reasons why it is well documented that shorter meetings and more breaks helps ease this fatigue. Just as you move from your conference room to another office, or a child moves from classroom to classroom, we have to simulate that experience at home. So head, shoulders, knees, and toes. Easy to remember, right? So what's next? protocols and etiquette for Zoom. Just as we had to do this for email, now we're finding ourselves in the position to needing these for Zoom too. And I am more than happy and willing to share the connectivity and body language piece on Zoom. Now there's a lot we don't see of our body language through that screen, but what we do see is clear and amplified and easier to learn and to teach. The greater picture. Some things coming out of this pandemic will be positive. I, for one, hope curbside pickup is still with us in 2024. Why not keep more remote working for our parents and caregivers? Why not keep that Zoom call with grandma on the weekend when we live so far apart? Maybe we shouldn't be so quick to return to some sort of status quo just because this transition has been fast and furious. We have an opportunity to listen to our thought leaders, our psychologists, and our neuroscientists, and intentionally create a better way of moving through this new normal. We can productively navigate through this newer way of building relationships. So embrace Zoom. Head, shoulders, knees, and toes, and wiggle your way to your next meeting, and make it a great one.